So there I was, washing my face. Mirror screamed ugly. Said you ain't gotta like me, but you'll learn to love me. I am the company that will forever keep you, the only existence that you can't see through. I am your self-esteem in which your dreams feed through. The backtrack, flashbacks and the previews, the concerns that burn your firm reviews and keep you from sleeping at night. Right then I was stuck, stood still frozen, trying to find the fuck, but mouth dropped open. Knowing this was all for real, I kept my nerves concealed as her words would steal my undivided attention. Her voice got a lot softer with each single sentence. She mentioned the lifestyle of a smile, the self-portraits and the morbid side profile. The cornered and the docile, she said walk in the slow aisle and ignore the mobiles, but make sure you stay in touch. She said some of us are gonna end up corrupt with abrupt brush strokes of dry lies, because the truth is harder to sell and the smarter survive. The harder you strike, the more they will run. Be careful not to lose sight on how far you have come. The numb feeling you're dealing with will fade, and it'll make more sense as you continue to age. This hip-hop life might seem like a phase, but fear this is it to remain engraved. The rage will build and the moments will open a still frozen frame that sets the picture of kill the lame. But your name needs not worry while they scurry to pile on dirt and cover up the work you insert. Their words won't be worth a thing. I felt a pin-like sting seeping into each pore of my skin, like boredom is a sin. And then within several seconds I saw my face start to melt within the reflection. Smile sagging, eyes bagging, earlobes dragging on the bathroom tiles. I was practically shitting myself. She said, this is an image of a scene that needs help, but you were insignificant and must play with the different cards you've been dealt. The bitches in this business are only out for themselves, and that bitterness that dwells amongst your own personal hell is like heaven to many who stepped in with a rather large weight on their shoulders. You can see the faces get colder and the soldiers start to lose his mind. You've been given a living, breathing, self-believing beauty who is truly just one of a kind. Find that content bench to park in, and you may bargain with the pardons. I'm sorry, the sorry excuse they use to spill a splash of juice will not hold up in your views. Your truth is coming while the sarcasm is flooding the dust-ridden streets. Close your eyes and listen to me speak, cause there's a point to be reached. I did as she wished and I swear I felt a set of cold lips kiss me. I opened my eyes to find there was no me in that mirror. I scanned the glass but there was no face, no body, just some cubicle doors. This was a nothing I'd never seen before. Time stopped as I watched in awe. I paused and then gained composure. I was curious, I wanted some form of closure. So I moved closer and I asked her, are you God? She replied, no, I'm just that part of you you're yet to get to know. Your moment of clarity.